Hello! You must have seen similar videos like these on social media. In this video, I'll show you step by step how to create such a video for free online in Google Colab, and also how to make the effect that the character from your video will seem to step in out of the frame. But before we start, there is one thing I would like to tell you. I used an AI-generated voice for my previous videos because I had a lot of trouble with my pronunciation. Believe me, it was impossible to listen to. That's why I was using a slightly improved clone of my voice. Now, after much training, I'm happy to speak to you in my normal natural voice. So I hope you don't mind the use of AI voice in my previous videos. It will support me in further training my English pronunciation so that I can make these videos for you. And just for fun, how many of you will recognize that? Let me know in the comment section. So, back to the video. If you don't want to generate a video like this, and you want to generate something from your video, you will need an init image. So, to demonstrate this, I downloaded a video from pexels.com. Once you have your video shot, you can use any video editor to find the desired frame and cut it out, or simply take a screenshot of it using any video player. After that, you can click on the link that is in the video description, and it will take you to the Google Colab environment. There are many parameters to set here, but don't worry, you only need to set a few of them to create a basic video. First, you have to select the Stable Diffusion model that you want to use to generate the individual images. There are a few to choose from here, but you can upload any custom model if you want. Then enter the location where you saved that model. I will use the default for this video. In the animation section, choose 3D mode for the animation effect and set the maximum number of frames. This section allows you to set the motion parameters for your video. You can choose how you want the camera to move in the video along the X, Y, and Z axis. For example, the camera will move 15 in the X axis on the 15th frame, 7 on the frame number 30, and so on. The same goes for rotation. Here you can turn on the 3D depth warping option and set the field of view. If you want to use your entire video as a reference, you have to upload it to Google Colab environment and name it here. But you need to set up the video input in the animation section. In this section, you can set your prompts. Enter the number of the given frame and the prompt you want for it. You can add several prompts depending on the number of selected frames. This is entirely up to you and your creativity. You can specify the width and the height of the image here. And here is a little tip for you. If you want the effect that the character from your video will seem stepping out from the frame, enter the values for the widescreen image here. For example, this image, it has these values, so you can simply swap these values between each other. And yeah, that's all. But back, if you don't want this effect, put the same value as the init image. Then, here is necessary to choose this sampling method and the number of steps. The higher value, the better for the quality of the result. After that, check Use Init Image box. This tells Deforum to start generating images from your extracted image. You need to put the init image location here and here. It can be any link to image or any location in Google Colab or your Google Drive. Then you just set up FPS for the final video and where you want to save it. The default location is your Google Drive. Once you have all this set up, you just go to the Runtime tab and click on the Run All, and it will start everything. It will first prompt you to grant access to your Google Drive, so that everything can be saved and then all the necessary dependencies will start to download. Once it's done, the video will start generating in this section. You will find the result on your Google Drive in the folder AI, Stable Diffusion, Date, and Stable Fun. In the next video, I will show you how you can generate videos only in a certain part of the image and thus achieve, for example, this effect. If you like the video, let me know with a like and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification so you don't miss anything. Thank you for watching.